Hello everyone. Today I am going to start a new chapter, that is how do organisms reproduce. And before this we have studied about the topic life processes. In the process of that chapter, life processes, you might have seen so as to consider an organism whether it is a living or non-living. There are few processes which we have to focus on, like breathing, respiration, digestion, excretion. All these processes are necessary for the survival of the organism. But this is the another process which is, although directly you can't say that it is necessary for the survival of a particular organism, but this process is sure shot necessary for the survival of the species. Kaise? Let's see. See, from your parents you came into existence, and your parents came into existence because of their parents. ठीक है? If there is no reproduction, then can you imagine how the species is going to continue? Okay, for the continuation of the species, there must be a process in which there will be the origin of the new organism, which is of the same kind of its parent. Okay, so this is what we are going to talk about today. So this is the process in which we are going to deal that. This process is, although not required for a particular organism for the survival, but it is necessary for the survival of the species. Okay, so it is a special biological process related with the production of new generation of individuals of the same species. Koi bhi species, it may be the species of the dog, species of the cat, species of the rat, okay? Species might be mammal. So all these are particularly different species. So as to continue the species should reproduce. So the reproduction is not an essential process for the survival of an individual. It is essential for the multiplication of the species. किसी भी species को, किसी भी प्रजाति को बनाए रखने के लिए जो process required है, that is known as the reproduction. Reproduction may be defined as the production of new generation of the individual of the same species. Because whenever we are going to talk about the reproduction, then we will be particularly taking any species. क्यों species का population बढ़ रहा है? Whenever we are counting the population, that time you must be knowing the counted population basically stand for the human being. तो जब आप population की बात करते हैं, that time you have not taken into consideration the population of the cat, rat, mice all together. So that time we are talking about only one species, that is the human beings. Okay, so in this way you can see that we are having n number of species on this earth. Okay, so it is basically the production of new generation from the pre-existing. ओके, जो पहले से एग्जिस्ट कर रहे हैं, दैट आर फिजिकली इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ देयर पेरेंट्स. व्हाट एवर द प्रोजेनी विल बी देयर, इट विल बी फिजिकली इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द पेरेंट्स. आफ्टर ऑल, रिप्रोडक्शन इज नॉट नेसेसरी टू मेंटेन द लाइफ ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल ऑर्गेनिज्म. किसी भी इंडिविजुअल के सर्वाइव करने के लिए रिप्रोडक्शन की जरूरत नहीं है. अनलाइक इट इज द असेंशियल लाइफ प्रोसेस, लेकिन ये एक असेंशियल लाइफ प्रोसेस है, जैसे कि न्यूट्रिशन, रेस्पिरेशन, एक्सक्रीशन. ओके, ऑन द अदर हैंड, इफ एन इंडिविजुअल ऑर्गेनिज्म इज गोइंग टू क्रिएट मोर इंडिविजुअल्स, अ लॉट ऑफ इट्स एनर्जी विल बी स्पेंट इन द प्रोसेस. ड्यूरिंग दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ एनर्जी एक्सपेंडिचर इज देयर. So the question arises, why the person should go for the expenditure of this much energy? It would be interesting to discuss the possible answer. Whatever the answer to this question is there in your mind, it is obvious that we notice organism because they reproduce. Agar har species ka ek hi organism ho, can you imagine ki aapko wo species dekhne ko bhi milegi? No, it's not possible. Okay. If there were to be only one non-reproducing member of the particular kind, एक member है वो भी reproduce नहीं करता है. कैसे reproduce करेगा? Because it requires another partner. ठीक है? Then there is no question that another organism will be there into the picture, or the origin will be there. If there were to be only one then non-reproducing member of the particular kind, it's doubtful that we would have noticed its existence. आप उसको देख पाए ये possible है या नहीं? No one knows. It is a large number of organism belonging to the single species that bring them to our notice. एक ही species के कई सारे organism हैं. That is the reason you are able to see a particular species. ठीक है, अगर एक ही होगा तो आप नहीं देख पाएंगे. सारे individuals कैसे imagine कर सकते हैं कि उस एक organism को देख ले. How do we know that two different individual organism belonging to the same species? कैसे हम ये जानेंगे कि ये दो individual एक ही species के हैं? Usually we say this because they look similar to each other. Similarity here means the characteristic feature. Okay, like one nose, two eyes, the sort of mammalian characteristic, having the mammary glands. These many characteristics will be same when we are talking about the same species. Okay. Do organism create exact copies of themselves? Exact copies of themselves basically means when we are talking about the amoeba or the paramecium, they are unicellular organism. Then whatever organism they are producing, it is almost same to that one. But you might have noticed that when we are seeing ourselves, then we are not at all the identical copy of our parents. You are not at all the exact Xerox of your either father or your mother. Actually, you got the characteristic features from both. Okay, that is the reason you are not exact copy of your parent or with your another brother or sister. You are not the identical copy of anyone. So organism look similar because their body design are similar. But we are talking about the species. So our species ke characteristic to same hai. ठीक है, इफ बॉडी डिजाइन आर टू बी सिमिलर द ब्लूप्रिंट फॉर दीज डिजाइन शुड बी सिमिलर. अगर सेम बॉडी डिजाइन बनाना है तो क्या चाहिए? द ब्लूप्रिंट शुड बी सिमिलर, मींस द जेनेटिक मेकअप. दस रिप्रोडक्शन एट इट्स मोस्ट बेसिक लेवल विल इन्वॉल्व मेकिंग कॉपीज ऑफ द ब्लूप्रिंट ऑफ बॉडी डिजाइन. तो अगर सेम स्पीसीज मेंटेनेंस करना है तो क्या करना पड़ेगा? ब्लूप्रिंट सेम बनाने पड़ेंगे. इन क्लास 9th वी लर्न दैट द क्रोमोसोम in the nucleus of a cell contain information for inheritance of features. In class 9th you have studied about the cell organelle, that is the nucleus, which is known as the control center of the cell. It was containing chromosome inside that nucleus, and the work of the chromosome is to inherit the character from one generation to another. And the component which chromosome are having was DNA, that is deoxyribonucleic acid. And that deoxyribonucleic acid was basically making the particular sort of proteins. So the DNA in the cell nucleus is the information source for making proteins. So DNA mein kya rehta hai? Protein banane ka source rehta hai, blueprint rehta hai. If the information is changed, अगर उसके अंदर कुछ भी थोड़ा सा चेंज हो जाता है, उसकी कोडिंग में चेंज होता है, तो प्रोटीन अलग अलग तरीके का बनने लगता है, डिफरेंट सॉर्ट ऑफ प्रोटीन. तो डिफरेंट प्रोटीन्स विल इवेंचुअली लीड टू ऑल्टर्ड बॉडी डिजाइन. अगर माइनर सा भी डिफरेंस आता है उस प्रोटीन के फॉर्मेशन में, तो जो इंडिविजुअल बनेगा उसका बॉडी डिजाइन में चेंजेस दिखाई देंगे आपको. Therefore, a basic event in reproduction is the creation of DNA copy. This is the important start point for you. So, reproduction का जो एक event है, basic event है, उसमें जो सबसे important part है, that is the creation of DNA copy. So, whatever the DNA copy the parent will be having, it has to be generated. One more copy need to be generated, then only it will be given to the progeny. Cells use chemical reactions to build copies of their DNA. तो सेल्स क्या करते हैं? कुछ केमिकल रिएक्शंस के थ्रू डीएनए की कॉपी जनरेट करते हैं. दिस क्रिएट्स टू कॉपीज ऑफ द डीएनए इन अ रिप्रोड्यूसिंग सेल. तो रिप्रोड्यूसिंग सेल, जो सेल रिप्रोड्यूस कर रहा है उसके अंदर डीएनए की दो कॉपीज बनेंगी, एंड दे विल नीड टू बी सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम ईच अदर, एंड बोथ द कॉपीज आर गोइंग टू बी सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम ईच अदर. हाउएवर, कीपिंग वन कॉपी ऑफ डीएनए इन द ओरिजिनल सेल एंड सिंपली पुशिंग द अदर वन आउट would not work. ऐसा नहीं है कि जो पेरेंट है वो एक डीएनए कॉपी खुद की ओरिजिनल रख लेगा और जो मल्टीप्लाई किया है उसको पुश कर देगा प्रोजेनी में. इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज द कॉपी पुश्ड आउट वुड नॉट हैव एन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड सेलुलर स्ट्रक्चर फॉर मेंटेनिंग लाइफ प्रोसेस. तो उस खाली डीएनए की कॉपी से वो पूरा लाइफ सर्वाइवल नहीं कर पाएगा, उसके लिए बहुत सारी और चीजें भी चाहिए, लेट्स सी व्हाट। देयरफॉर डीएनए कॉपिंग इज एकम्पनीड बाय द क्रिएशन ऑफ एन एडिशनल सेलुलर एपरेटस। इट नीड टू हैव अ एंटायर सेलुलर स्ट्रक्चर, देन ओनली इट विल बी एबल टू सर्वाइव, नॉट विद ओनली डीएनए। एंड देन द डीएनए कॉपी सेपरेट each with its own cellular apparatus, then they will be, when it will be getting separated, then they should have all the components which is required for the survival of life. For example, mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, lysosome, all these things needed by the other cell also. So if they are going to keep the original DNA and giving only one DNA copy to the progeny, then it will not work. Progeny also required all the components whatever the parent is having. Okay, effectively a cell divides to give rise to two cells, and when cell division will be there, the normal cell is going to produce two daughter cells. Two daughter cells will be having all the components which the parent cell is having. Okay, these two cells are of course similar, but they likely to be absolutely identical. Zaruri nahi hai ki wo identical hi ho. The answer to this question will depend on how accurately the copying reaction involved. If there is no error in the copying, DNA copy agar hu bahu ditto copy bana di gayi hai, so might be they will be identical, but usually aisa nahi hota hai. So no biochemical reaction is absolutely reliable, therefore it is only to be expected that the process of copying of DNA will have some variation each time. So whenever they will be generating the DNA copy, that time only the variations are going to happen. Variations kya hote hain? Variation wo minor changes hote hain jo DNA copy karte samay aate hain. To variations ki wajah se kya hota hai? We are not identical to each other. That is all. We are having some sort of differences among each other. That differences are known as variations. As a result, the DNA copies generated will be similar but may not be identical to the original. DNA copy jo generate ki gayi hai, wo similar to ho sakti hai, but identical nahi ho sakti. Means clone nahi ho sakti. Some of these variation might be so drastic, and sometime during the DNA copying, jab DNA ki copy ban rahi hoti hai, us waqt bahut sare variation ho jate hain. कई बार इतने ड्रास्टिक होते हैं दैट द न्यू डीएनए कॉपी कैन नॉट वर्क, और कभी कभी जो डीएनए कॉपी बन करके आती है वो नॉन वर्किंग भी होती है. ठीक है, विद द सेलुलर एपरेटस इट इनहेरिट, तो जिस सेलुलर एपरेटस के अंदर वो डीएनए बन करके आया है वहां पे वो काम ही नहीं कर पाता. सच अ न्यू बॉर्न सेल विल सिंपली डाई, और इस तरीके का जो सेल होता है इन विच द डीएनए इज नॉन फंक्शनल, इट इज गोइंग टू डाई बिकॉज this DNA or the which is the component of the nucleus itself is a control center. If this control center is not working, then how the unit will be working? On the other hand, there could still be many other variation in the DNA copies that would not lead to such a drastic outcome. Most of the time it usually happens, the DNA copying, although they are having a minor variation, but it is not that much drastic that cell is going to die because of that. Thus, the surviving cells are similar to, तो जो survive करते हैं cells, similarities होती हैं उनमें. The way you have seen the similarities in the, your family members, a similarity with your class mates, but similar in basic body design, but we are not identical to anyone. Okay, but subtly different from each other. This inbuilt tendency of variation during reproduction is the basic of evolution. This part you will be doing in the next chapter. But for right now, you should know the evolution where the sort of gradual change, जो ape से लेकर man तक बनने तक का जो process था, that is known as the evolution. The same way evolution happens with all the species. सारी स्पीसीज का अपना अपना इवोल्यूशन है. दे आर इवॉल्विंग, दे आर गेटिंग डेवलप्ड विद अ मोर एडवांस बॉडी डिजाइन. सो देयर बॉडी डिजाइन इज गेटिंग मोर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. द वे द एप यूज टू वॉक, द एप यूज टू लुक इज क्वाइट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द प्रेजेंट मैन, एंड दिस एंटायर ग्रेजुअल प्रोसेस इज नोन एज द इवोल्यूशन. दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट the reproduction for today. This is basically the introductory part, and in the next phase we will be entering in the detail. At that time, do this much. Thank you.